Good morning all. I am Dr. Dinesh, Senior Interventional Cardiologist from Warangal, Telangana. I am a director of Samraksha Super Speciality Hospital, Warangal, and also Irona Clinic, Dr. Dinesh Heart Clinic in JPN Road. So, I have been practicing in Warangal for the last 12 to 13 years, and I can say I am the first interventional cardiologist for Warangal. Yeah. When we consider the possibility of heart failure, or the incidence of heart failure in India is almost 1 to 2%. It means in every 100 people we find 1 or 2 people with heart failure. So when we take the total Indian population, there are some crores of people with heart failure, living with heart failure, suffering with heart failure, and also dying because of heart failure. Yeah. See, the inability of the heart to pump, the weakness of the heart to pump can develop because of various factors. The most common thing, the most common factors are diabetes, most commonly alcohol, and also when we see in the villages, it is the what we say is arak, that is gudamba and all those. Those lead to heart failure. So when we, how to control, how to help ourselves to not to get into heart failure is, when you have diabetes, it is always important that you control it properly. Most of the times the patients, what they do is, because I am not feeling much hungry, because I am not having any tingling sensations, because I am not having any sweating, my sugars are under control. That is wrong. You should always check your fasting blood sugar, post-lunch blood sugar, and also the 3 months average HbA1c, glycosylated hemoglobin, and maintain it in the proper levels. And so next is hypertension. Hypertension is increase in the blood pressure. Whenever there is increase, there is more load on the heart. For an example, when we can, మనం ఒక పని కొన్ని ఒక లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ పని చేయగలుగుతాము, దానికి మనం డబల్ వర్క్ చేస్తా వెళ్ళామనుకోండి, ఒకరోజు చేస్తాం, 2 రోజులు చేస్తాం, 4 రోజులు చేస్తాం, వారం చేస్తాం, దాని తర్వాత మనం చేయలేకపోయి మనకు నీరస పడిపోతాం. సో వెన్ వీ టేక్ ఏ లోడ్, ఓవర్లోడ్ ఆఫ్ వర్క్ ఫర్ లాంగ్ డ్యూరేషన్, వీ కెనాట్ వర్క్ అండ్ వీ బికమ్ వీక్. సిమిలర్లీ, when the heart is pumping against a high blood pressure, as the time goes, it fails, it becomes weak and leads to heart failure. Then the most important thing is alcohol. The what happens is, once the person is habituated to alcohol, because of his financial status, they keep on going for a cheaper type of alcohol. And because of the cheaper type of alcohol, arak, gudamba, all those, they lead to the myocyte dysfunction, that is cardiac cell dysfunction, that leads to heart failure. And next is the smoking. When you are habituated to smoking, smoking is what we call it as atherogenic. Atherogenic means it creates blocks in the blood vessels. So when there are blocks in the blood vessels of the heart, the blood supply to the heart decreases. As when we eat less, we cannot work properly, or when we cannot work to our efficiency. Similarly, when the blood supply to the heart decreases, then the heart fails. So in this way, controlling of diabetes, controlling of hypertension, avoiding alcohol, avoiding smoking, and also having good physical activity can help us in not falling into the problem of heart failure. And most importantly, most frequently seen is coronary artery disease. So all these risk factors, the diabetes, hypertension, smoking, alcohol, everything, they cause the blood vessels supplying the heart to narrow and that leads to heart failure. Yeah. See, whenever you are diagnosed of heart failure, don't get panic because of the possible treatments. There are like medical managements are there. Then there are many interventional managements are there, and many devices are there with which we can prolong our life, with which we can make our heart better. So when we take the management of heart failure, we have different headings like lifestyle management, then the medical management. In the medical management, it comes to the medicines and it comes to the devices. So taking all these into consideration, if we take one by one, when we take lifestyle management, once you are diagnosed to have heart failure, you should always restrict your salt intake. Restriction of salt intake doesn't mean don't take salt at all, but you can take the salt to your taste. When you are cooking something, up to the taste you can add the salt, but don't add any over and above your requirement. That is, don't add salt in your curd rice, don't take any bakery foods, don't take any prepared foods, that is tinned foods, and don't take any pickles. All these, the bakery items, the pickles, the tinned, stored food, they all have a lot of salt because salt helps in storing it for longer. So when the salt is more, salt is nothing but sodium by chemical. This sodium has the property of catching the water and it increases the body water content. So whenever there is increase in the body water content, the load on the heart increases. The load on the heart increases, then you have more failure. When you have more failure, you are more sick and you cannot do your activities. You may be bedridden. That is the lifestyle management. And regarding the medicines, there are many medicines available now, like ACE inhibitors, ARBs, diuretics, Lanoxin, Arni. There are so many medicines which your doctor would take care. As a patient, what you should do is you should stick on to your medicine schedule. And if you have any problem with the medicine schedule, you approach your doctor and take their opinion and take their advice. Most commonly, the medicine which causes trouble in heart failure patients is the diuretic, that is medicine which helps in passing of more urine. The problem here is you are overloaded with fluid in your body, so we need to remove that fluid. For removing the fluid, it is like a sponge filled with water. You cannot see the sponge with water. You cannot see the water in the sponge, but when you squeeze the sponge, the water comes out. Similarly, the water in our body, it cannot be removed with a needle, because whenever we say the patient, your lung is filled with water, what they say is, can't you remove it with a needle? It is not like that. A lung filled with water means a sponge filled with water. Only when you squeeze the sponge, the water comes out. Similarly, we squeeze the lung with medicines. That helps in removing the water, whatever is there in the lungs. That goes out of the body as the form of urine. So when we start these medicines, most of the time the patient has to attend the bathroom frequently. And they realize that that particular tablet is making them to run to the bathroom many times. So they avoid the tablet. Diuretic in the treatment of heart failure is like salt in our cooking. However good you cook, however delicious you cook, unless you put the salt in appropriate quantity, the taste of that dish will not be appreciated. Similarly, any number of medicines you use in heart failure without a touch of diuretic you cannot get an efficient result. So in the medicines, and when you go to the devices, like there are number of devices like CRTD device or pump devices, all those devices are in a later stage where we are not able to improve ourselves, where our heart failure is not improving in spite of maximum number of medicines in the highest dose, then we have to go for the devices which help in reducing the load of the heart. It is like the device only helps in pumping the blood to the various organs, giving rest to the heart. So all those devices, like they are available when and they are usually used in the later stage of the disease. See, once we get into the heart failure, I already said, don't panic, because many of the heart failures, when taken care right from the diagnosis with all the precautions, they definitely revert back to normal. Most of them, they revert back to normal. So what we have to, whenever we are diagnosed to have heart failure, see your risk factors. If you are diabetic, have a strict control of diabetes, take your doctor's advice properly, follow it properly, and see that your diabetes is under control. If hypertension, see that it is under control. If you are an alcoholic, stop alcohol totally. Most of the time they say, will there be any problem if we stop the alcohol suddenly? Nothing happens but for craving. Your feel for the alcohol, you want alcohol, only but for that sensation, nothing happens. Where in some chronic alcoholics, there can be a withdrawal effect for which we can take tablets. We need not go back for alcohol and relieve the symptoms, because your heart failure is going to worsen with alcohol. So control of diabetes, control of hypertension, avoidance of alcohol totally, and if you are a smoker, quit it to the 100%, and never think of even being sitting next to a smoker. So avoid tobacco to that extent. And regarding the diet, as I already told you, you have to take the salt in a restricted quantity. And one more important thing is, because there is more water quantity in the body, we have to take less water. That is a very misleading concept. So for a heart failure patient, whenever they are taking this diuretic, the urination medicine, they can have one glass, that is 200 to 250 ml of water, whenever they attend the toilet. But this is in particularly not applicable when there is a kidney problem also, because when the kidney is not able to remove the water, you loading yourself with water may worsen the situation. So when there is no kidney problem, only heart failure, then you need not restrict yourself totally by 1 liter of water a day or 1.5 liter of water a day. But whenever you attend the toilet, you can have 200 to 250 ml of water. So that will help you in not going to weakness, not going to decrease in your sodium potassium, that is dyselectrolemia, and it will help you in facing the heart problem comfortably. So whenever you have heart failure, don't panic, don't get depressed, follow your doctor's advice properly, and if any medicine is troubling you, or you feel that you are having a discomfort with any of the medicine, don't just stop. Visit your doctor, take their advice, and he will be a proper decision maker whether to stop that drug or change the drug or decrease that drug. So the decision for yourself will be harmful for you. Take care of yourself properly, by taking proper medications, proper diet, proper physical activity, and definitely 100% following your doctor. Thank you. You can come out of heart failure when you take all the precautions. Similarly, you can also prevent yourself in getting into the problems by taking care of those risk factors. And always the risk factors, the diabetes, the hypertension, the stress factor, the smoking, alcohol, these factors should be taken, given a proper attention and a proper care, and whatever is needed, you need to do for that. When that is for the this one, and the physical activity, the most important thing, a person who has not come into the heart problems category or a person with heart problems, anyone can do the physical activity to their maximum capability. So a person who is very much fit, he can walk every day 6 kilometers per hour for at least half an hour for 5 days a week. And a person with heart failure, he can have a 6-minute walk. That is, he will walk at his own speed for 6 minutes in his corridor or in his hall. In that way, you increase your activity. When you are able to walk your 6 minutes without any trouble, then increase the time or increase the speed without any discomfort. In that way, gradually you get into more fitness. And definitely never let any of the care you take when you are sick. Once you get better, don't neglect them. If you follow all these points, you will definitely improve day by day. It is not a one-day program or it is not a one-month program. You will be alive only if your heart works. So you need to take care of your heart throughout the life. So, and the most important thing is, many of the patients feel that it is lifelong medicines. It is not lifelong medicines. These are the medicines for long life. So you need to live long life. You need to take care. Whatever care you need to take, you have to take.